Hey everyone, a very good morning to all of you. So today we are going to discuss a lot of interesting questions like Financial Inclusion Index, eCrop Initiative, BRICS Agriculture Research Platform, Neeraj Chopra's ranking in the World Athletics Ranking, and the RBI's Banking Regulation Act. Actually, this Banking Regulation Act is a question for you guys. This is not something that I am going to discuss here. That is the static question for you all that you have to answer in the comment section below. But that question will be given to you at the end of this video. So let's watch this video till the end of this till the end of this video, okay? But before that, before beginning, you have to subscribe and hit the bell notification because this is going to help you in staying connected with our channel. And guys, you can join this Telegram group as well. Here you will get the PDF of this session. Okay, so the very first question that we have is related to the Financial Inclusion Index. So what is the score of India in RBI's Financial Inclusion Index for the period ending March 2021? So out of these many options, the right answer is this. Guys, this score of March 2021, I will tell you what does this score indicate. But first you need to know that the score is given on a scale of 0 to 100, where 0 means complete exclusion, financial exclusion, and 100 means complete financial inclusion. So this score is indicating that we have come halfway in providing financial services in achieving the financial inclusion, and half work is yet to be done, okay, towards achieving full financial inclusion. Now let's move on to this index. But before that, let me tell you that this index, basically RBI announced that we have constructed such kind of an index during its Monetary Policy Committee meeting of April 2021, okay? And right now the details of this index as well as the performance of India on this index has been provided. So this detail has been released recently. The very first thing that you need to know about this index is the purpose of launching this index. So it is very evident from the name itself, financial inclusion. This index is going to assess the performance of different sectors in achieving the financial inclusion. Guys, financial inclusion is not at all confined only to providing banking services to the people in the remotest areas, okay? Banking services along with investment, insurance, pension, and all such kinds of dimensions that have a financial implication as well as societal impact on the lives of many people in India are covered in this index. So let's see how many sectors are covered: banking, investment, insurance, postal, as well as pension sector. So these are the sectors on which the financial inclusion will be assessed in this index. Next comes the score. So this we have already discussed. The score for March 2021 is this. For March 2017 is this. Okay. So do remember both these scores in comparison to the last score, that is 43.4. India has achieved a significant improvement here. Okay. Now, there is no base year of this index, as we had a base year in digital payment index. Do you know what the base year was for the digital payment index? The base year is March 2018. Do remember this as well. So DPI's base year was this, but Financial Inclusion Index does not have any base year because this is measuring the collective efforts of different sectors towards achieving the financial inclusion. Therefore, there is no base year. Publishment, this will be published annually in July. Parameters. Now guys, three broad parameters are there: access, usage, quality. And all of these have been given weightage. So this percentage is the weightage. Highest percentage is given to usage, lowest is given to quality. Weightages are important for you to remember, okay? Now, all these broad parameters are divided into dimensions. Then dimensions are further classified into indicators. So a total number of 97 indicators were used to prepare this index. Do remember this number as well. Now, what is the function? The function is to achieve ease of access. Basically, if there would be a financial inclusion index that will measure the performance of different sectors, this will obviously give an impetus to the sectors to perform better so that the score of overall India can be improved. Okay, so this will give a push to different sectors so that they can perform better in financial inclusion. So how can they perform better? By providing ease of access, availability and usage of services, and quality of services, by providing qualitative services. Now, this quality of services is a unique feature here, because this is not only catering to the supply side, this is not only assessing the performance of the supplier side, that is the pension fund regulators or the insurers. This is also assessing the consumer awareness, the financial awareness that the consumer has, financial literacy that the citizen has. Okay, so financial literacy of the consumer protection, inequality and deficiencies in services, all of these will be assessed in this index. That makes it a unique feature of this index. So that's all about this financial inclusion index, guys. Now let's move on to the next question. What is the name of the brand of urban self-help groups products under Day NULM? First of all, Day NULM is Deen Dayal Antyodaya Yojana, National Urban Livelihood Mission. So under this mission, basically the livelihood opportunities are created for poverty alleviation so that poverty can be removed in urban areas. Do remember, so this scheme is administered by Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs. Recently, the ministry has announced a brand name and logo for the products created by the urban self-help groups. Products like textiles, toys, every product is covered. So what is the name of that brand? The name is Son Chiraiya. This is the name of this new brand name, brand and logo of the products that are created by urban self-help groups. Now guys, do remember that under this National Urban Livelihood Mission, the ministry not only focuses on creating opportunities for the self-help groups and micro enterprises, but also the ministry or the government is focusing on creating meaningful job opportunities for the poor people residing in the urban areas. So that is the purpose. Now your responsibility is to cover this scheme thoroughly for your phase 2 examination, okay? And as far as this question is concerned, all of the current news we have discussed. Moving on to the next question, which state has launched the e-crop survey initiative? Gujarat, Tamil Nadu, Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh, Telangana. Out of these, Maharashtra is the right answer. So this e-crop survey has been launched by Maharashtra Department of Revenue and Agriculture in partnership with Tata Trust. Now what is the purpose? Basically, by using the e-crop survey application, the farmers can register their crops, register themselves on their own, and by registering themselves, they can registering their crop and everything related to the crops and related to them on the portal. They can easily get loan against crops and they can also insure their crops. So that is the benefit. So it is basically making this whole process hassle-free for the farmers. That is why this application has been launched. Apart from this, there is also a portal launched by the Maharashtra government that provides the digitized 7x12 document. This is the land record document. Okay, so this is also provided digitally to the farmers in the state of Maharashtra. All this digitization is being done to make the entire process hassle-free for the farmers. That is the basic purpose. Next is, which country has developed the BRICS Agriculture Research Platform? So guys, this platform has been developed by India. And recently, the working group of BRICS on agriculture has met virtually, and during that meeting, two important things were highlighted or discussed in detail. First one was this agriculture platform, and second one was the agriculture plan on cooperation from 2021 to 2024. So what is this all about? Let's discuss that in detail. So as I have told you that the working group on agriculture met recently, the theme of the meeting was this: BRICS partnership for strengthening agro biodiversity for food and nutrition security. This meeting was chaired by India because India is the chair of the 13th BRICS 2021 summit that will take place in the next month. This platform has been developed by India to promote agricultural research, extension, technology transfer, training and capacity building. So all these activities will be undertaken by the BRICS countries through this platform. And why are they undertaking all these activities? The purpose is basically to improve research in using the technology in agriculture sector, to improve the usage of technology in agriculture sector. That is the purpose. Next point is that action plan of 2021 to 2024 for agriculture cooperation was discussed, and it will be adopted during the BRICS summit. Now you need to remember the edition of this summit, that is 13th. Okay. Next question is, what is Neeraj Chopra's rank in the World Athletics ranking of men's javelin throw? So the ranking is second, and who has come at the first rank? It is Jonas Wetters. So he is also a javelin thrower. Guys, where is the headquarters of World Athletics? It is in Monaco. Do remember that. So guys, this is the question that I was talking about in the beginning. This is the question for you all. I'm going to just read it and leave it to you. Which section of the Banking Regulation Act 1949 empowers RBI to penalize banks for non-compliance? So these are the sections in front of you. Do mention the right answer in the comment section below. You have heard or read the news about RBI penalizing different banks for not following the rules, not complying with the RBI's guidelines. Now you have to tell that under which section of Banking Regulation Act 1949 is RBI allowed to penalize the banks? This is your question for the day. Do tell me in the comment section below. And thank you so much for watching today's video. And do not forget to watch the session on treaties and conventions at 10 a.m. today itself. Thank you.